Hi children, welcome back to our English class. Today I am going to explain about a grammatical aspect, that is prepositions and articles. Before we are going to class, how are you all? Yes, hope you safe at home. Yes, what is mean by preposition? Let me know what is mean by preposition. What is mean by preposition, children? Actually, it belongs to preposition belongs to parts of speech family. Yes or no? Yes. What is mean by preposition? Preposition examples. So many examples are there. What is that? In, on, at, under, above. Number of them. So words like this. Words that are used to show the relationship between noun or pronoun and other words in the particular sentence. What is mean by prepositions? Words. What are the words like this? Words that are used to show the relationship between noun or pronoun and others and other words. What are the other words in the other words in that particular sentence? So you can take one sentence. Okay, my book is on table. My book is on the table. This is example. So here my book. Here you can take subject. That book is noun. So what is the relation between book and table? Here where is the book? On. Then what is it explains us here preposition? The place where it lie means where it is there. So place. So this is about definition. Coming to the next one, still continuation, that is how can we know that relationship? So how can we know that? First thing, where it is the that object. Okay, and when it happened, like time and where, either place or position. We are using prepositions always. Hope you understand. Yes, prepositions we can use always before noun. Always before noun or pronoun. And it tells about the position. Position, time and place. So it explains how like this. A class starts at 10 a.m. Okay, at particular time we have mentioned here. So at is the preposition here. A class starts. So relation between time here. How like it is? At. So time slot that. We have decided that. Okay. And this is about time. Before that, before example, it indicates place. On the table. Yes. Coming to another example. Now position. Cat is sitting under the bench, under the sofa, whatever you can make.
Where it is?
Under. The position of the cat. How like it is? Sitting under the cat. So, position, time and place. In here, what we have to learn? What we have to learn? What is important to learn in prepositions particularly? We have to know first the preposition. What is meant by preposition? And where do we have to use? So, we have to know the prepositions of place and time. You can write like this, time and place also. Place and time. So, we have to know about this particular aspect. How do you know that? We have to remember that. So many number of prepositions are there. Between, among, beside, besides, under, beneath, over, up, into, in, all there. So, how can you know that? As we know that triangle. Yes, in maths you are very very interested aspect. This is interested, no? So, with triangle method you can remember a things. How like it is? You see here. This is a triangle. I divided into three parts. In place and time, most probably we can take three prepositions. Three prepositions only. At, on, and in. So, these three prepositions we can know about this. So, relation between both. So, at, on, in. So, where we have to use at, where we have to use on, where we have to use in, how we can recognize those? Everything is here. See, at. It's very, very smallest thing. It's a very specific and smallest one on. It's not like smallest but smaller. It is smaller. So we are specific this. This is also specific, more specific. It's not like at. It's more specific. This is also specific. Next, in. In general, we can use this in general, okay, using for bigger, for example, large. We are talking about any large places or large events, then we can use this in. Is it clear first? Next, I will explain. One by one. At is in the smallest. It's a very specific. At 9 p.m. time. Okay. At 25 Street Colony. Like we have to mention that number. This is about. And at we have to come the time particular. Time we have to be mentioned. That is known as at. It's a smallest thing, very smallest thing. That is very specific for us. In these two aspects, what are those two aspects? The place and our time. We have to know both time and place. I will explain next. At, on, is it smaller? We are using it smaller. On, like names of days on Monday. On Monday. And more specific means, we are saying floor, on the fourth floor. We are leaving the surface. We are talking about surface on the fourth floor. Like we have to be specify here. In is a large. Whenever we are talking about place, countries we have to be mentioned here. In India. State in Telangana, city in Hyderabad, like. Here, time. Then what about the time? Time means years. In 1999, in 2012, like years we have to be. Okay, even we are saying about holidays. In summer holidays. Here, in summer holidays. Seasons, in winter, in monsoon. Like we have to use in a large aspects. Okay, so in particularly we are using in a large aspects. This is smaller than in. This is the smallest. In the sense that is very very specific. Very very specific. Keen. Yes. Is it clear to you? Yes. Coming to time and place. Where we have to use an example. Dear ones, here I am writing place. Okay, all. Here time. How we have to recognize yet about place. So whenever we are saying anyone, our address, we have to be specific or not? Yes or no? If you say any ambiguity for them, so they couldn't get your address. Yes or no? So you have to be give addresses using at. How like you have to be give at 45 street, something, any number that is your call, street name is there, no? Oh, so 45 street. Like you have to be give address specific. And coming to time. Coming to time. How like we have to be using any moment of that particular time. Any moment of that particular time. Any moment. We can take any moment. That moment we have to be saying time. So at that moment. How can we say that? We really frightened at that moment. So we are talking about at here. And one more thing here. We have to mention specific location. Specific location. Location in the sense, for example, any Ramalayam temple is there. So you have to be give that a specific landmark, Ramalayam. Okay, like at Ramalayam, at the temple Ramalayam. You can give like specific location using at. Here, parts of day. Parts of the day means for mostly at night, at midnight. We can say that talking about night, particular part of the day. So we have to write night, at night. Yes or no? We are celebrating the party at night. At night. So this is about at. Rest of them we can see that. Next, coming to, this is about time, children. Using at, place. Yes. So now coming to on. For on, we are using on in a specific things. How like we have to use? For example, here streets we can say. Streets means you have to be use name of the street. For example, any surnames, most probably in that street means that corner of the street, surnames there. For example, Gubbalavari Street. Gubbalavari Street. Like you have to be specific this. Specific. Is it clear? And one next surfaces. What I have said, just I give example on fourth floor. First floor, you have to be mentioned that. Surface in the sense floors. Where you have in apartment so many floors are there. So you have to be specific. Coming to on. On means what I said? Days. Days. On Monday. On Tuesday. On Thursday. Even though sometimes we can use on before dates. How like? Days. On April 1st. On April 1st. So, you can use like this also. So, B before days and before days we have to use am. And one more thing is we can use in that specific moment on my birthday. Events are there, so on my birthday. So on that particular day you have to be mentioned. Yes, this is about on. And here place here. So this is it clear now? Yes, children. Hope you understand. Coming to in. What he said in for place means countries. Countries means how like in India. Yes or no? Yes, this is country. And state, Telangana. Any state you can take. And cities, city, Hyderabad, Ahmedabad, Hyderabad. You can take anything, Aurangabad, that is district. So here states you can take, cities you can take. Yes, Aurangala means that is city. So this is about in. This is large. This is place. In here, time, years. Before years we have to use. In 1990. Here, in 1990. We are talking about that. Holidays. We got holidays. So we are doing something. So I want to do, you are planning for that. So I am going to do in summer holidays. In summer holidays. We have to mention that. Okay, and one more thing, seasons. Actually, I want to go, that is season. I like monsoon season. So, we have to say that in monsoon season, we enjoyed a lot. In monsoon season, we enjoyed a lot. So, this is about season. So, what way we have to use? Actually, this is a more specific. And it's a bigger, large object. Whenever we are talking about large places and years, we have to use this. Yes, children? Yes. Hope you understand now. This is a simple method you can remember what are the preposition we have to use, where we have to use in, on, and at. Yes, coming to your textbook. Children, this is grammatical part. See here, read the following sentences from your lesson and observe how the underlying words are used before the names. Names of dates, the names of years, and the names of places. So, you have to be know first what, observe that. Then you can understand prepositions of time and place. Raman was born on November 7. On, I say, before dates. Yes, on. Okay, in 1970, particular year we can mention means in we have to use. And at presidency college, that is specific, very specific, the college name they mentioned. So, at presidency college in Madras, in is a city name. So, Madras here, city name. So, before that, in either used. In December, months also you can use December. But whenever date is there after the month, what you have to use? On. Is it clear? Yes. This is note is there. See, in, on, in, and at are prepositions of time and place. How many are there? Three. So, in sentences 1 and 2, they give explanation to you. The on used before the name of a date. Yes or no? And in sentences 2 and 3 and 4, in used before name of year. Here. Yes or no? And before the name of the month also. In sentence 3, it is used before the small place. That is smallest one. I already gave in triangle. Yes. Coming to here exercise children. That is only about one person, a paragraph. You have to be complete that with what are the prepositions here, there. In, at, or on. Large areas means we can use in. A small place, that is we have to indicate with yet. And on is before dates and before months. Is it clear?
Yes.
Dear one, coming to next aspect, ours, articles. What is our aspects? Articles. See, actually this before that, these are a part of parts of speech. Later on that, every maybe sometime before that they divided as an articles is a separate aspect because it has so much importance. So what is mean by articles and how many are there articles? Whenever we have to mention in that one particular sentence, for example, I am a teacher and they eat an apple, okay, and the Red Sea. So whenever we can take a phrase or group of words, we can use. So here a, an, the, these are articles, children. These are articles. So maybe you have seen in your books, and even though you have across all these words, because while you are writing, you'll get this. Yes, a and these. This is already in previous classes you have learned this, but this is a revision for you. A means particular, we have to talk about one person here. Teacher, I'm a teacher. And one apple, they eat an apple means they eat only one apple. And the Red Sea, particularly Red Sea is one specific thing. So whenever we are talking about any specific things, we can use the. That even though the use in superlative, before superlatives also, we will discuss. First, what are the articles here? A and the. Okay. Yes, these are the articles. Now coming to how many types of articles are there? Two types of articles are there, children. That is definite article. Okay. And indefinite article. Indefinite article. Once remember, already these you have learned before only article. So here definite article, indefinite article. Definite article means how many articles are there here? A and the. These are the articles. So here this is definite article. And a, an, or the indefinite articles. What is mean by definite article? What is mean by indefinite article? Definite article, we have to specify things. For example, we are talking about a person or any things. We already mentioned before that. So we are repeating that. So we can use the there. Specific things. Specific things. For example, I bought a red pen and a blue pen. Okay, a red pen, a blue pen. But I like the red one. I like the red one. Means red pen. You can pen also give. Here, see, once observe this. I bought a red pen and a blue pen. This is first time they mentioned a red pen, a blue pen. That's what they use a article here. But whenever we already know about this. That's what they say. But I like the red pen. What I mentioned here, two pens. In the two pens, what I like here, the red pen. In the blue and red, I like red pen. So specific. So here specified that. And one more thing, superlatives. Superlative, that is definite. We have to say that definitely, that is specific. That's what the use. And before superlatives, we have learned already adjectives, noma. Three forms of adjectives: positive, comparative, and superlative. So, superlative, before superlative. For example, the biggest. Biggest. What is the EST there? Those words superlatives. And one more also, the most. The most powerful. Actually, powerful is an adjective. So we can't say that powerful or powerfulest. So what we have to use? More and most. More powerful and most powerful. So here, the most powerful. Here also we can use. So whenever we are taking superlatives in adjectives, the forms, before the superlative forms, we can use the. Is it okay? Yes. Hope you understand. Yes. Coming to indefinite articles. Indefinite articles A, N, AN. A, N, AN. Where we have to use? This is, we have to remind and remember ourselves sounds of the sounds of the letters. Here letters are not important. Here sounds are important whenever we are talking about A and N. How like? For example, vowels and consonants. Once recollect your knowledge, children. Vowels and consonants. As we know that in our English, 26 letters are there, but 44 sounds are there. How many letters are 26? But sounds are 44. In that, vowels and consonants. Vowels and consonants. Actually, in this, 5 vowels and 21 consonants are there. But sounds, regarding coming to sounds, 20 vowel sounds are there and 24 consonant sounds are there. So, here we are considering not letters. We are not considering letters. We are considering only sounds. Consider the particular word start with sound. So, vowel. So, where we have to use? Whenever we can use an before vowel sound. Before vowel sound. A before consonant sound. Either that is phrase or word, or that is total class like that. Word. That word must be sound like vowel means and we have to use. Sound like a consonant means A we have to use. Yes, I will give example. Then you can understand. Yes. Here, what I say? Vowel sound, no? Apple. 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 Actually, what is the pronunciation? Apple. But some, always we can say apple. But apple. Either A or A, those are vowels. In Telugu also, Achilu Halilu. So, vowels and consonants. So, apple. So, we can use an. An. Is it no? Yes. Coming to orange. 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 So, an. An. University. University. Once pronounce this. University. U. University. So, what we have to use? A. Why I have to use here? U. Actually, this is a vowel. But here, what is this? Sound is like consonant. University. Union. Union. A. But onion. Onion. And. Is it clear though? So, where we have to use? Before consonant sounds, A we have to use. Before vowel sounds, we have to use an. Here, one more example, children. Maybe you are confusing this. R. What is this? R. What we have to use? Maybe 90% of you, you said A. But A is wrong. What we have to use? An R. An R. Here, H is silent. We can't pronounce that. How can we use the A? An A. So, A. A. A is a vowel. An A. This is about articles. Hope you understand. Yes. Now, coming to your textbook. Yes, dear ones, this is your textbook revision of articles. So already we have learned articles once revised. So A is used before singular common nouns in noun phrases beginning with consonant sounds. What is that? University, union, is it not? Yes. And is used for before singular common nouns in noun phrases beginning with vowel sounds. One object we are talking about, that is pronounced like a vowel sound, before that what we have to use? And the specified. So how many points are there? 4 points. Before words are phrases that indicate unique things, that is specific, special things. It was the headquarters of the Indian Association for Cultivation of Science. Yes or no? IACS. So that is headquarters. We are talking about a specific thing. So the you can use. In institutions where the sentences itself contains a clue to identify of the thing or the person referred. Example, his advice to young scientists was also to look at the world around them. What is the advice? After lesson, we have see these all. In social situations where the identify of the person or object is identifiable, means identification we have that. So we have to use that. But look here Krishna, he said turning the young man. So whenever he is saying turning the young man, so that object, that is specific for us. Before the names of musical instruments, the guitar, the violin, that is the we can use. He studied how string instruments like the violin. Yes. List 20 phrases from the text that began with A, an, or the. Then put 1, 2, 3. A means here already they gave no. What is the reason we have to use before A, before an, or before the? So we have to be mentioned there in brackets. Why did you use that? Why will you choose that? That reason you have to be put in brackets. That is an exercise for you. See here, they done an old building. An old building. Why they are using old here? You have to be right here in bracket the reason. Here some examples. Fill in the blanks. So Swaminathan, because this is the different various examples they gave. You have to be choose correct article before that word and write. Okay, ma? Yes. Yes, our last aspect, that is very small one. Paragraph. How do we start paragraph? As we know that we are writing any essay, or maybe in competitions, essay writing competitions, or we are writing any question answer for that particular question, we are writing paragraphs, no? How like we start the paragraph? Here children, paragraph means one main idea is there. Okay. One main idea is there. We have to describe this idea. Describe this idea with many examples, quotations, like situations we can take. So, we have to develop this main idea with our thoughts, examples, quotations, whatever we add this. So, how like we have to write? 3 steps are there. What is the 3 steps? Topic sentence. First, topic sentence. Second one is supporting sentence. And third one is closing sentence. We have to start. Topic sentence means we are talking about, we can take an example, we are talking about this laptop. Okay, you can take this topic, any topic that is. Topic sentence, what we have to write? First, we can give the definition of that particular topic sentence. Why we are choosing laptop? Okay, what is mean by that? And next two are there, no? So what will about? So we are giving some told about. So in the topic sentence we can write two or three sentences about introduction. About introduction. So we are taking any topic. So you can take any example. I said just now lockdown. So introduction. You have to give introduction of the main idea, that is lockdown. And next you can write about that. What is mean by that and how we have suffered. So two or three sentences enough in topic sentence. That is first part. Okay, paragraph. First, so three paragraphs we can write in three paragraphs, three stages. Topic sentence we can write introduction and two or three sentences in that. In the supporting sentence, you can give examples. Okay, you can give means elaborate that. You can elaborate that, expand that. Expand that with supporting sentences. Supporting sentences, examples or any situations, events. Okay, events. You can take anything, quotations regarding that main idea. Regarding that main idea. What I said just now here, lockdown, that is only my idea. You can take your own topic. Okay, if they give, if they will give any questions for you, to you, then you can answer related to that question. So introduction, explanation with examples, supporting sentence you can start with example. Okay, closing sentence means conclusion. Dears, we can conclude our main idea with effective words. So conclude, this is closing sentence in the sense conclusion. So how many paragraphs you have to write, right? Paragraph means three parts. One is topic sentence, second one supporting sentence, third one is closing sentence. In topic sentence, what you have to take? Any topic you can take. Introduction you have to be said in two or three sentences. And in supporting sentence, you can elaborate, you can expand that topic with an examples and any situations. Closing sentence, that is the last paragraph, you can give conclusion for that main idea. Or you can take any precautions for that. You can give your suggestions in that closing sentence. This is about paragraph. Hope you understand, children, what we have learned today. First, prepositions of time and place is very, very important to you. Then, articles, where we have to use, where we have to omit. And one more thing, paragraph. How to write paragraph. How many sentences you can right. Now coming to our textbook. Yes. Here, dear, this is a writing part, children. This, actually, this is not a grammatical one. So, writing part. How to write paragraph? Here, page number 31. Write a paragraph on Jesse Bose. Jagadish Chandra Bose. Using the hints given below. They gave some hints to you. You must use the right linkers to join the sentences. To join the sentences. So here links are this. That means hints. They are cutting here. See, J.C. Bose, Indian scientist, born 1858, St. Xavier School, Calcutta, like that. All information they gave in hints. So you can take that blanks and write paragraph. Three types. Here three paragraphs you can write about J.C. Chandra Bose. This is about paragraph. Hope you understand, children. Is it clear? Yes. We'll continue in next class. Thank you.